The Restoration Trilogy, originally published at the Last Bestia blog in 2015, read to you by the author. Music courtesy of Alex X Aces Patriots. This work is licensed under a Creative Commons Attribution, Non-Commercial, Share Alike 4.0 International License. Any other content within this work that may not be covered by this CC BY NC SA license is hereby used under the sincere intention of fair use. No copyright infringement intended. Preface. Amongst libertarians and patriots alike, there seems to be a predilection towards wishful thinking, recognizing the warfare-welfare state as one expression of authoritarian power is a good starting point, but then refusing to acknowledge that all taxation is theft, because taxes infringe upon individual property rights, is simply absurd. Philosophizing about what the Founding Fathers had to say is time well spent, yet believing that expatriation will remedy all of your political grievances is just naive. Mentioning to people that their natural right of self-defense is also applicable towards police officers is excellent, however, attempting to guilt this same audience for not using politically correct lingo is nothing less than unconscionably offensive. My intention with this publication of these short fictional stories is to illustrate not only the nature of the situation we are all suffering under, but to also highlight the foolish as well as treacherous actions which exacerbate the tyranny ruling us all. Themes of compromise, appeasement, and betrayal abound in this creative work as more of a warning to readers to be wary of most so-called activists who tell them to do this or to do that, and especially those whom attempt to guilt-trip them for their failure to perform these actions. Once you understand that these manipulative rock star divas who infest the alternative media, spread misinformation and even disinformation to their audiences, then I trust you can begin to understand, at least in part, why I felt this trilogy had to be written by someone. More importantly, I felt that it was high time that those who sincerely consider themselves to be freedom fighters have something resembling a vision for what they desire to achieve. Chronicling the evolution of human liberty from the European absolute monarchies through both the American Revolution and the subsequent Whiskey Rebellion, I found it no small task to also futuristically extrapolate what the restoration of constitutional government might indeed look like. In the attempt to do just that, I figured it would be important to also describe a foreign country doing something similar at about the same time, but seeing as this wouldn't make sense for the Iranians to do, I chose the Korean Peninsula as the role model, thereby reversing the historical timeline, in a sense, of the French Revolution. Should anyone like to take these stories and develop them into a full-fledged novel, or even a feature-length film, I would wholeheartedly encourage them to do so. If anything, these stories are explaining the transitional phase from our current political situation to parts 1 and 2 of The Plan for the Restoration of Constitutional Government. Hell, a cinematic trilogy about the plan would be even better, because that would demonstrate more specifically how the current Anglo-American Empire could be thrown off, as well as how the several American republics could be successfully restored. A truly inspiring movie trilogy, rivaling in popularity to that of The Hunger Games or Atlas Shrugged, about securing our liberties would tickle me pink something fierce. Kyle Reardon, Austin, Texas, January 2015. You have just heard the preface to The Restoration Trilogy, originally published at the Last Bestial blog in 2015, read to you by the author. Thank you for listening, and laissez-faire.